I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain. All right, I wanted to do a video today because it marks the day, 1 year, since we lost one of the, definitely one of the greatest people I met, probably the greatest man I met so far. And wanted to do sort of, I guess, a tribute video because, you know, most what I see on social media is the world knew him as a great fitness model. And, you know, people when he died are saying, oh, he was the greatest, great body, great physique. And want to do this video because I think that doesn't do him justice. I think his body, his accomplishments as a fitness model, really a 1% of who he was, what he was about. So wanted to, I guess, pay my respect, my tribute a year later, because I stumbled across Greg in 2010 or 11 when I was in a very low, dark, down place, not knowing what I was going to do with my life, very victim mindset, very weak, no belief, and probably wasn't the best person just in general. And through his membership site, I was just fascinated, and what that video did, these videos did, was really gave me some strength, gave me some new perspectives, that mindset, and really took me from rock bottom to someone that had some resilience, that had some integrity, had some character, that had some belief in the self. And I definitely got that all from him. He was incredible guy. You got to watch his videos and you'll see his passion, his enthusiasm for not just helping people, but for life, for others. He was truly at service to others. And I think him dying young is kind of, you know, there's a sadness to it, obviously. But there's kind of that, you know, he wanted to be remembered. He wanted to leave a legacy. He wanted to leave his mark on the world. And there's some magic when people die young, where the words are somehow become more meaningful. They somehow have a little bit more impact. And I think that was kind of his mercy. And I truly think that his, you know, his number one goal was service to others. He was here to serve. He was one of God's angels, one of God's servants, whatever you want to call it. And he was, that was his almost like his sacrifice of, like the universe said, you know, you were here to make a difference, to send a wave across the world, help a lot of people, and if you want to be remembered, we're going to have to cut you a bit short, buddy. So that's mercy. So, you know, that's sort of my positive spin on it. You know, so in 2000 and right, well, you know, a few months before he died, maybe 6 months before he died, was able to spend a bit of time with him, and we brought him out for an event, and man, this guy produced probably one of the greatest talks I've ever seen. Just full of passion, enthusiasm, but it wasn't the talk that impressed me most. I was able to spend probably 4 days with the guy, you know, 6 months or less before he died. And just to see the character behind the camera, you know, off the camera, to see the quality of person he is, was nothing. It was like nothing I've ever seen. And to see how much he cared about people was great to watch. It really was. And you know, the short time, you know, I remember on one of the nights for dinner, you know, everyone got a little rowdy, and he's picked up the waitress, and he's, you know, having a laugh and having a good time. And obviously the managers weren't too happy with that, and we're driving back the next day, and he's just like, man, always get myself in trouble, but you know, man, he's like, I just want to see people have a good time, enjoy themselves, put a smile on their face. And I was just like, wow, this guy is something else. He's yeah, very special dude. And you know, after a talk, people really saw him as a messiah. They threw their whole, all their problems, all their life's problems on him. And you know, he sat for 2-3 hours after a talk, just with this line of people, you know, just really listening, really engaged in, you know, anyone and everyone, every walk of life. And you know, I'd never seen someone of that stature with that compassion for people. And although he you know, he was brutal though, but it come from love. You know, he was, you know, he'd call people out. You know, people like, Greg, I want to be the next fitness model. And he would just be straight up, and you know, you might see this as aggression, but it comes from a place of love. He's like, yeah, well, you're about the 500th person that's lined up here and told me that. Why the fuck are you gonna be any different? And you know, at first I think people were a little shocked, but they really saw, I think once it sunk in, that it did come from a place of love, that you know, that he wanted to help, and they appreciated it, they loved him for it. And yeah, just truly a great guy. It's so giving away, you know. And you know, a few months later I got to spend a little bit of his time over at his house, and you know, as a guy that's not, you know, you rock up, he's not showing you all the covers and look who I know and look at me on movie set, never mentioned any of that. You know, what he prided himself on was family, and you know, who he'd helped. And he's, you know, he was showing me, you know, all these gifts he made for you know, for his uncle and his, you know, people that he cared about. And it's like, this guy is just so selfless. And I think you know, from what I, this time I spent with him, and I think people maybe took advantage of that. And he was, because he was so giving. And I remember, like, I paid for like a salad or something, like $40, and 2 days later he's like, man, thank you for that, you know, you didn't have to do that. And you know, it was like, really appreciated those small things, because I think people spent their whole lives sucking his energy, feeding off his energy, his enthusiasm for life, his passion for life, or his finances, or whatever it may be. So just a super loving guy, hard as nails, which you need to be in this world, but one of the most loving, caring people I've ever stumbled across. He was a shooting star, you know. He was not here for a very long time, but boy, did he light up the world. Did he light up so many people's lives, and mine included. So you know, without stumbling across him, I don't know where I would be today. Just made an incredible impact, but not just the impact on helping me be success. It was really helping me become a better person, and be a person that cares about others and does the right thing, and has some character and integrity behind what they do. So you know, if I can do half of what the great man did in this life, I mean, I'll be knocking on heaven's door, and he'll be there waiting. So thanks for everything, buddy. As I said, I hope I can make it up and do half what you can, and have a beer waiting for me. I'm out.
They say dreams are things that, you know, that you see when you're sleeping. I say bullshit. I say dreams are things that keep you from sleeping because you can't wait to become it.
The pain you feel in here, guys, it's temporary. As long as you continue to push through it, that pain will always be temporary. Pride will be forever. If you quit, then that pain will last forever. Nothing's impossible. Just a spelling of impossible.
It's spelled impossible. Perception on how we see things, guys. We create it or we destroy it right here. We either give birth to our fear, we blaze the path of our dreams. You're either living your dreams or living your fears, one or the other. And which one are you giving the most time to?
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you
live once, but if you work it right, Once is enough, my friends.